see the nurse. Get the dressings changed. It's Friday, so it's Luha. A very twisty, windy road, this one. Probably more suited to a small bike than a big one. Although it is a main road, it is very windy, twisty, and in places quite narrow. But it affords some nice views. Oops. That on the hill there is the village I'm going to. And here we are. This is Leuhart. Park up to the doctors in a few minutes and pop in, get everything done and get back to you later. Okay, finished with the doctors and nurses, got everything done, dressing's done, new pills ordered. New bags ordered. Dressings feel nice and comfortable. Perfect, sun's shining, skies are blue. Riding back down from Leuhart. Off to Castel, have a coffee. Decide what the rest of the day is going to be. Usually not much, just lately. Came up a bit, went up the valley here. Not a problem. It feels nice and cool. You have to be careful about not over-inputting on these little scooters. You can't push the front like you can on the ZZR. You can't counter-steer violently. It just makes them unstable. All the inputs on these are very small and very gentle, progressive. But as long as you do that, brilliant little tool. They're more like riding a push bike than they are riding a motorbike. I don't know what the big maxi scooters are like, 400, 600, whatever. Never tried one. In fact, this is my first scooter ever. And although it is officially a maxi scooter, it has more to do with the physical size of it and the wheelbase than it is to do with the power. So it is only a 125. It is only a 150 two-stroke, so it doesn't have the power of a modern maxi scooter. They still make. A 125, I think, version of this. X something. And a 250 and a 400 and a 600, I think, if I remember that. X8, X9. I believe. They dropped the hexagon name. For whatever reason, I thought it was quite fitting, if you've ever seen that. The Piaggio badge. Which is hexagonal, I believe. Definitely feels breezy here. And then it is a bit exposed, as you can see. But it is a lovely place to live. Gorgeous. If you happen to be a biker, some of the best roads you could ever imagine. And as you may have noticed, not a lot of traffic. And people constantly raving about the fantastic roads up in the Picos de Europa, which they are. Again, it is a mountain road, so you'd expect curves and switchbacks. You can't just keep on driving tunnels through mountains. Sometimes you have to go round, or up, or down. Oh, a car. But down here on the south coast, we are also just below a mountain range, Sierra Nevada range, proper mountain, with a people will probably be skiing there today. I think the season started early. We had a lot of snow early on. But it's quite a sight. I prefer to look at it from down here myself. I like it warm. Not a great fan of cold. So between the mountain range and the sea, About an hour in a car on the road. We have the foothills. Las Alpujarras. And the Contraviesa. So most of the roads around here are pretty much the same. Up and down. Twisty, twisty. Some very, very tight. Some fast and flowing. That's the nature of the landscape. The beauty of this over the Picos is that not many come down here. It's an extra day's ride to get down. About 800 kilometres, and therefore you pretty much have the roads to yourself all year round. And you can ride all year round. Down here we don't get frosts, we don't have snow. It can get cool. Certainly damp. Then it's not much different to any weekend in the UK. Any time of the year. And it's worth it. The only times I hesitate to ride are the height of summer and it's too hot to put the gear on. On the big bike I'm definitely Napcat. All the gear all the time. I hate to see people, and there are people around here, well, some parts of them, who ride around on sports bikes in shorts and flip-flops. Not an uncommon sight. But generally, if you see anyone in full gear here, they'll be a tourist. But on the scooter, there's headed to town for a bit of shopping or a coffee or whatever, I do tend to be gas, as I like to put most of the gear all the time. Riding down there alongside the Rambler into Castel, grab a coffee and a bit of breakfast, have a think about what the day's going to bring. typical. No indicators. Bad. Road position. All the usual things you expect from Spanish drivers. That, and they do tend to brake in the corners. And brake for every corner. Even on motorways, you'll find them braking for the corner or curves. And most of them find it pretty much impossible to stay in the lane, wherever they are, whatever speed they're doing. They are, in a word, rubbish. So, keep your eyes open, wits about you. Right, here we are. Destination Caffarini. That was known as the office.